MrExcel from MrExcel, episode 1397, Call 'em Wider. Hey, welcome back to the MrExcel netcast. I'm Bill Chellin. I was doing a live seminar out in South Bend, Indiana, one of my last live seminars yesterday, and a question came up about making columns wider. Now, of course, you know how to do this. You know three different ways how to do this. I mean, we can come here between C and D and drag it out, or we can double-click between C and D, and it gets exactly that wide. Aha. But there's other ways. And those other ways become really, really important if you're on a worksheet like Sheet 2. This is where someone went to View and they turned off the grid lines. They turned off the headings. It's the headings that really matters. Because now when the headings aren't there, hey, there's nothing to click. Oh, no. What am I going to do? Right-click. Nothing in here will change those columns. Shoot. This is why it's kind of important sometimes to know every way there is to do something. The old format column width in Excel 2003 has been moved to the Home tab. It's let's get this so you can see it. Out on the right-hand side, there is a format dropdown. In the format dropdown, column width or autofit column width. I'm going to go to column width, and you actually have to enter a number, and it might take a little bit of experimentation to figure out what the right column width is for you. But certainly, if someone's turned off the display of those headers, you're going to have to go back this method. All right, so that kind of threw me for a loop. She's like, oh, I can't drag the column anymore. I'm like, what do you mean you can't drag the column? And then she explained the headers were gone. I'm like, oh, okay, so we have to go back to the old method. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast, Mr. Excel.